3:20 in the morning and we're heading back home because we forgot our passports. Well, it's 19 miles to go. We've made up some really good time. Hopefully we'll get on the right train.
Fingers crossed.
Good timing. We've just got here, straight on, ready for the queue. One, if you book a high vehicle, it's wider, you don't damage your alloys. To Monaco, you go on this road we call the corkscrew. It goes down and down and round. It's really steep. So whenever you're on a steep decline, always check your exhausts.
Hola.
This is the Raskas bend and the start finish straight. That's the pit lanes behind there. And just up here, in a number one spot. It's hopefully where Max will be on Sunday. Driven around here about 20 times. This is the casino hairpin, probably one of the most famous bits of the course. I remember riding around here on my old Ducati years ago. In the morning on race day. They reckon there's a 60% chance of rain today. So I'm taking my coat, be sorted. Just gone 8 in the morning and the rain is starting to ease off a bit. We're on our way to Monaco. Hopefully there'll be a little bit of rain today and Max will do it.
Or Lewis.
Or Max.
Or Lewis.
It's a little V8. But we have found an underground car park near the palace. Bit of a squeeze to get in, but nice little British McLaren. Yeah, see, this is the thing with McLarens. They're to a penny.
Avec Michael Amermuller aux commandes et celui qui a réalisé un bon départ, c'est Yann Schanguven. Il était 6e sur la grille, il est 5e maintenant, Yann Schanguven. Un bon départ également de Jarl van Engen qui était 8e sur la grille, qui se retrouve en 6e position maintenant. C'est moins bien parti par contre pour Dylan Pereira avec la numéro 3, Julien Rondeau. Albums souvenirs en bonne place, hein. Gagner à Monaco c'est quelque chose et on le voit au visage rayonnant d'Alexander Smoliar. Les applaudissements de leurs athlètes célébrissimes, le prince et la princesse, et qui sont présents au pied de ce podium également. Et puis on va célébrer tout ça maintenant, champagne. De ce Grand Prix de Monaco avec ancien et bien ma foi quelque peu mis en place pour la grille de départ, ce qui a permis à Charles Leclerc d'en gagner. Mercedes à laquelle on a assisté, va-t-on avoir un peu de changement, un peu de modification, de variété à Monaco? Ma foi, la première ligne est toujours cadenassée par Mercedes, on verra comment on va aller.
Traffic jam. Whilst Nicky's on her phone googling for a nice fish restaurant. Another beautiful sunny day in the south of France. There's Monaco and Nice. And in the distance, snow-covered mountains. lovely.
That's cool.
Yours too.
Thank you. She followed.
We've just been fed. There's a subway just outside. I bet they're quite into the tuna.
We're just going through a toll road. You'll see our tag system works. Brilliant. Anyway, we're leaving on Thebes. We're going past Monaco, just over that hill. Bye, Monaco. See you next year.
Bye, Monaco.
And we're heading to the snow-covered mountains in northern Italy, a town called Aosta, or something like that, maybe not quite, where they filmed the beginning scenes to the Italian Job.
You're only supposed to blow the bloody doors off.
We haven't got a Lamborghini Miura, but we are in a V12, and I have got Matt Monroe ready on the stereo.
Now that's sad.
On days like
very this, sad. Da 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 da.
Quando vieni il bel sole. Molto bene.
I wish you'd turn this song off.
Our hotel.
We're going to have a little walk up there later on to a nice traditional Italian restaurant. There's the view. Absolutely breathtaking, my dear. Place. Help yourself to tea and coffee. Well, don't mind if I do.
Ready for dinner? With that view. This is the Mont Blanc Tunnel. Miles and miles of perfectly straight tunnel. Costs you 46 quid. And you don't even get a free pen.
last night. How's it been?
It's been absolutely fantastic.
And this is the chateau we're staying in. And we've just had dinner over there with loads of weird things that we've never had before. Very nice.